Hello, I'm Amy Clark, Senior Research Assistant in the Arts of Africa, Oceania, and the Americas at the St. Louis Art Museum. Ancestors are central to Maori culture and feature prominently in the movie Whale Rider and works of art in the museum's recently reinstalled Oceanic Collection Galleries. Whale Rider is a film written and directed by Nikki Caro in 2002. It is based on the novel The Whale Rider, written by Witi Ihimara in 1987. The film stars Keisha Castle Hughes as Paikia Aparana, a 12-year-old Maori girl battling to overturn the patriarchal traditions of her tribal community. Paikia's mother dies in childbirth, along with her twin brother, who was to become the new leader of the tribe. Paikia was named after a mythical descendant who founded the village upon the back of a whale. Paikia's father immigrates to Europe to pursue a career as an artist, leaving Paikia to be raised by her grandparents. The grandfather, Koro, resents Paikia for being a girl. He doesn't believe she is able to lead the community into a new age of prosperity. With the hope of finding a new leader, Koro gathers all the firstborn males to teach them the ancient culture and traditions. Despite showing much interest in the old ways, Paikia is excluded by her grandfather, who is adamant that a woman should not be involved in learning about tribal leadership. She trains in secret and remains determined to learn all she can of her ancestral customs. Meanwhile, none of the boys show promise as a leader, and Koro becomes withdrawn. Paikia prays to her ancestors for help, resulting in a number of whales stranded on the beach. The community is united in their unsuccessful efforts to lure the whales back to the ocean. It is Paikia's determination and her knowledge of the tribe's ancestors, or Whakapapa, that demonstrates her ability to be the next chief. Several works of Maori art in the museum's collection illustrate the themes of ancestors and changing traditions. The Maori are the indigenous people of Aotearoa, or New Zealand, located southeast of Australia. The founding ancestors of the Maori originated from eastern Polynesia and voyaged to New Zealand by canoe around the 13th or 14th centuries. Before the early 19th century, Maori artists focused primarily on carved figures and sculptural elements of war canoes, storehouses, and chiefs' houses. The model canoe is a small-scale example of a war canoe, or wakatawa. The largest of Maori watercraft, a real war canoe, carried 100 or more warriors to battle. Just as for a full-scale canoe, the bow, stern, and sides of this model were crafted separately and bound together. Feather attachments reference their use as navigational devices. Also on view are examples of a carved figurehead and stern that were once attached to a full-size vessel. The closing shot in Whale Rider shows Paikia and her grandfather with other members of the tribe navigating their community's rehabilitated waka. Around the middle of the 19th century, the need for war canoes diminished. Maori carvers redirected their talents to the meeting house, or Wharehanui. A meeting house is positioned within a marae, a communal and sacred meeting ground, which serves as a site for hospitality, discussion, teaching and learning, mourning, and celebration. The meeting house is the center of the local community and a powerful symbol of identity. This pair of relief carved panels, called popo, are just two of 46 carved for a meeting house that ultimately was never built. Hone Tahu, the Maori artist who carved the panels around 1870, is one of six master carvers of the Iwiraku school. This group of carvers produced works from about 1850 to 1920 on the east coast of Aotearoa's North Island. With a career that spanned over 30 years, Tahu solidified his reputation through not only his sculpture, but also by training the next generation of carvers. Tahu was commissioned by Kratiana Takamoana, a wealthy chief of the Ngāti Kahungunu tribe. Although Tahu and his workshop completed at least 60 carved components for the structure, the meeting house was never assembled. Following the sudden death of Chief Takamoana in 1879, the carvings were exhibited 10 years later in an exhibition in the city of Dunedin on the South Island of New Zealand. In completed meeting houses, the carved wood panels alternate with woven panels to decorate the interior. The popo figures represent ancestors, and an entire meeting house may be named after a specific ancestor. The popo are also functional. They support the meeting house's rafters. As pillars, the popo reinforce the importance of the lineage and ties to the land. Key concepts of tradition, sacredness, and power are embedded within the architecture of the Whanganui. Reinforcing the building's connection to a specific ancestor, the structure of the meeting house echoes the human figure. The ridgepole is the backbone, the rafters and side posts are the ribs, the gables the arms, and the veranda the head. The Whanganui provided more surface for carving and allowed innovation and experimentation. Artists were able to retain and break tradition through their carvings. The meeting house allowed carvers to demonstrate visual links to the past. Maori carving is an art form rooted in tradition. Carvers are able to tell stories from the past, but also reflect on the present. The rich symbolism of the carvings narrate communal histories and reinforce connections for future generations. The panels demonstrate Tahu's preference of asymmetry and range of tongue types. As an experienced carver, Tahu express movement and action by showing parts of the body going behind or through another part. On one panel, the two larger figures' hands go through the mouth and holds the lip. Thank you for watching this Art Plus Movies program. We invite you to share this link to connect family and friends with Art Plus Movies. You can also connect with us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube.